أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد
the surah. As I promised, we review the surah from beginning to end. This surah Al-Ma'ida. So this is the summary now of the whole surah. Surah Al-Ma'ida is a Madani surah, 120 ayahs. It is surah number 5 in the Quranic order in the Mus'haf, even though it is among the last surah, it is the last surah revealed. And it is mentioned in Ma'ida because of the Ma'ida came down to Sayyidina Isa and his people to eat from when he asked Allah Azza wa Jal for it. It was revealed after the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Medina, even though it was close to Mecca when it was revealed. One of the ayahs in it was revealed in Hajjat al-Wada', اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم, today I completed your religion, وأتممت عليكم نعمتي, and I perfected my favor upon you, Allah says. ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا, and Islam is I'm pleased with Islam as your religion. So this is an ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah, was among the last revealed. Sayyidah Aisha said that Ma'idah is the last surah revealed, with all the ahkam and all that. Whatever you find halal in it, follow it. Whatever you find haram in it, avoid it. Surah Al-Ma'idah had many ahkam of Sharia and three stories and many ahkam of the Sharia. What are the ahkam or the rulings of Sharia? The rule of contracts, the very beginning. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu awfu bil uqood. Rules of contracts, the rule of marriage, the rule of marriage of the non-Muslim, the people of the book. Man, Muslim man marries a woman of the people of the book. The rule of wasiyya at the time of death. The rules of halal food, the biha or hunting and the game. How about the rule of hunting while in ihram and the punishment for that or the expiation for that? The rule of tahara, purification, and wudu, and the ghusl from janaba, tayammum, rule of tayammum also mentioning, yani not exactly the detailed rules, but it's mentioned. The prohibition of drinking, prohibition of gambling. What is the punishment or what is going to happen if a person abstains from the religion or rejects the rules of the deen? The punishment for stealing. The punishment of threatening the safety of the community. The expiation for oath, yameen, to feed 10 miskeen or give them clothing or free a slave. Whoever cannot find can fast 3 days. Ahkam. The also how Allah Azza wa Jalla abrogated and prohibited the Sharia of Jahiliyyah to name certain animals with certain tasks or certain privileges and all of that. The punishment for those who abandon what Allah revealed, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all those ahkam mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah, the ulama said in this surah, there are obligations, 18 obligations that is not in any other surah, 18 obligations that is not in other surah. They said al-munkhaniqa, and not eating the choked animal, wal-mawqudha, the one that is hit with something, wal-mutaraddiya, the one that fell from something. Those are three prohibitions in regards to the food. Wal-natiha, the one that other animal killed, wama akala as-sab'u, يعني whatever the animals of prey killed as well. So whatever killed by an animal like it or by animal of prey. So المنخنقة والمنقوذة والمتردية والنطيحة وما أكل السبع. وما ذبح على النصب يعني whatever was slaughtered for other than Allah. This is six now. وأن تستقسموا بالأزلام that you use those oath of those arrows like omen, good omen, bad omen, yes, do, go, not, you know, that all of those. So those are seven prohibitions. And then the other obligation here, so prohibition is under obligation. You are obligated not to do or not to eat from that. Those are seven. Six things about food and one thing about qadr or about Allah's decision to do or not to do things. Then comes number seven, وَمَا عَلَّمْتُمْ مِنَ الْجَوَارِحِ مُكَلِّبِينَ about the hunting, the rules of hunting was never mentioned in any other surah. The teaching, the taught animal, the dog or the bird, or the, I mean the hawk to hunt, that's number seven. The food of the people of the book and the marriage of the women of the book. So those are nine here. منخنقة والمعقوذة والمتردية والنطيحة وما أكل السبع إلا ما ذكيتم وما ذبح على النصب وأن تستقسموا بالأزلام بذلكم فسق. And teaching the animals to hunt and the food of the people of the book, nine. And the marriage of the woman of the book, those are ten. وتمام الطهور يعني the wudu and the ghusl, that's 11. And the rule of the cutting of the hand of the thieves, that's 12. Do not kill the hunting, the game while you are in ihram, that's 13. And al-bahira, wal-sa'iba, wal-wasila, wal-ham. That is 4 plus 13, 17. The prohibition also of the animals at the end. So the animals prohibited in the beginning, and there are animals prohibited by jahiliyyah. Allah said they are halal. So this is the fard. So here animals people used to eat, Allah said this is haram. And the animals people prohibited, Allah said this is halal. So what they allowed, Allah said haram. What they prohibited, Allah said halal. Yani just to see. So that's 17. And then the rules of the wasiyya, 18. The rest of the fara'id or the rules in Ma'idah mentioned in other surahs. But those 18 only mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Imam Al-Qurtubi, he said there is a 19th one. And he said the adhan. It is never mentioned in Quran, adhan, except in this surah. إِذَا نَادَيْتُمْ إلى الصلاة وإذا ناديتم إلى الصلاة يعني when you call for أذان for صلاة the منافقين they start playing around or mocking it. So it's mentioned, أذان mentioned in the surah. Someone can come and say but in Surah الجمعة Allah عز وجل said إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة he answered the Imam Qutb and said this is only for جمعة. This is the adhan of Jum'ah, is not the adhan of Dhuhr. And Jum'ah can be out of the Dhuhr time, so it is not the adhan of the five daily prayers. So, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, there are many things that makes it unique and special. The deen is completed, mentioned only in Surah Al-Ma'idah. That the deen of Allah is the same, even if the prophet comes with different sharia, Surah Al-Ma'idah. Showing that the prophethood of Rasulullah is general for all mankind. And Allah ordered him with giving the call to all humanity. And his job is only to deliver the message. Allah Azza Jal told the believers to fix themselves and not to look to others who are deviated, even if they are the majority. And how to fix that? How to be on the straight path is to fulfill the contracts, is to do all the obligations that is mentioned. Allah told in Surah Al-Ma'idah that to help each other for good and not to help each other for the sin. And this is a major rule. تعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان. Major rule. All the mufassirin, the jurists, the muhaddithin, anybody talk about anything, they come from that rule that we supposed to help each other on good and avoid bad. To rule with justice, equality in the human rights between the men and between the Muslims and the non-Muslims. Allah Azza wa Jalla showed the ahkam of all the things that we eat, the prohibition of drinking and gambling, al-ansab wal-azlam, clear, only in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Al-akhirah, only Allah is the one who rewards. And what benefits at that time is saying the truth. So those are ahkam of Surah Al-Ma'idah, briefly. What are the three qasas, the three stories for admonition and for taking a lesson? The story of Bani Israel with Musa alayhi salam, when he told them to enter the land, he said, no, you go with your Lord and fight. So that's one part of the story of Sayyidina Musa with Bani Israel, mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah here, to see how they were, that iman were not sincere and deeply rooted in their heart. The second story is the story of the two sons of Adam. One of them killed the other. And this is the first murder that happened on earth. To learn also from that, how jealousy will affect the relationship of humans. And the third one is the story of the food that came to Isa alayhi salam, the story of the Ma'idah itself. Surah Al-Ma'idah, it was revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was riding his camel, so the camel could not carry him. So this is generally the ahkam of Surah Al-Ma'idah. Surah Al-Ma'idah is a great surah to memorize, to learn, to understand. I advise everyone to try your best to study Surah Al-Ma'idah again. And I would actually advise you to write down your notes, like we did in Surah Al-Kahf a long time ago, if you remember. So if we can listen to the recordings of Surah Al-Ma'idah from beginning to end and try to write something, write some notes, your own notes, about every chapter, every part of the surah. So this way, you kind of remember the surah as a whole, as one unit, and then you can make a map of it. And this is another thing I wanted to emphasize. So always have a map, mind maps. So Surah Al-Ma'idah, it is like the main thing. And under Surah Al-Ma'idah, as we mentioned, the 18 or 19 ahkam. And then there are three stories. And under each story, what are the lessons I learned? And under that hukm, what ayah number? To what ayah number? What is the, what I benefit from? I have a mind map. So when Surah Al-Ma'idah pops in your head, you can remember the whole map. If any rulings of that comes, the whole map also will pop up in your head, inshallah.